final event on the day three programme for finals and semi-finals. This is the second session of semis and finals on the day three programme on Tokyo 2020. Sees the men's 4x100 freestyle relay. Well, the fireworks are going to go off now, because across the board there are only eight places available into the final. The eight fastest teams will go through, and there's not a lot of space in a crowded ready room. Swimmers love swimming relays. This is the way they line up then. In lane eight for the Russian Olympic Committee. Kolesnikov coming in to anchor this team. The other three are unchanged. The European champions in eight.
Is Canada in lane number one. You see the lineup there. Brent Hayden, 37 years of age, made a return for these Tokyo Olympic Games. He'll lead it off.
Hungarians in lane seven. This is an unchanged team. Milak will lead them off, and Nemeth to anchor the team. They're in seven. I wonder what they can squeeze out of this quartet coming in on a 3:12.73.
Brazil occupies lane number two for this final of the 4x100 freestyle relay. It's a good team. They went 3:12.59 to qualify into the final.
France will have their eyes on a medal. They're swimming in lane six. They were Olympic champions in 2012, and they picked up a silver medal in Rio. Can it be three medals across three successive Olympics? They've got Florent Manadou coming in to the team. They will still be anchored by Mehdi Metella.
Here are the Australians in lane number three. Matt Temple comes into the team. Chalmers comes into the team as well. It's a good lineup. Olympic champion as the anchor.
United States always start as the favourites. They've brought in Caeleb Dressel. We haven't seen Dressel swim so far this week, but it's going to be a busy Olympic Games for the much-fancied American. They are the defending champions and the world champions and the world record holders.
Italy has never won a relay gold medal in swimming. Could this be the occasion that they do it? They were supreme in the heats. They were fastest qualifier by a second. Ah, it's going to be a good 4x1.
Well, this is the opportunity. We always talk about having to take opportunities when they present themselves, and they come around so rarely. Italy have been very well prepared. They were dominant in the heats. Here they are in the final. Could this be their moment? The United States of America have only made one change, so you might think that the team might swim faster from the 3:11.33 that they swam in the heats. Dressel will add a second and a half, possibly, to what the team can perform. Australia, with Matt Temple coming in on the lead-off. It's going to be drama, it's going to be a fight for the finish, and this is going to be very close. The final of the men's 4x1 freestyle relay. Matt Temple in four, Australians in lane three. Breno Correa in four, Brazil in two. The Italians have got Alessandro Miressi in four. Caeleb Dressel leading out the Americans, and you expect them to be given a lead. France in six with Maxime Grousset.
Wow, Dressel is just unbelievably quick in his first 50 metres. Now, that world record line that you see is the world record for the relay, not the individual 100 metres freestyle. But he is swimming very fast, 22.2 at the 50-metre mark.
Well, you can set a world record as an individual in the lead-off for the relay. Well, that's Cesar Cielo's world record down at 46 points, so Dressel giving them a lead. Very close between the Americans and the Italians. There's little in it. The Americans are in lane five. That's the golden lane closer to us. We're then pushed by France. In for France now, the huge sprinter, Florent Manadou. And France are
front-loading this with Manadou in the engine room against the second American in this. This is Blake Pieroni.
Great underwater by Manadou. Some fantastic lead-off times. Three swimmers going 47. Manadou swimming away from the USA, but the USA are fighting back with Pieroni. The Italians are trying to set themselves up to be up in the top three. Australia just losing touch at the moment.
So the midpoint, two down, two to go. The Americans are still in the lead, but not by much. Just in front of France and the Italians in third. This could change, though, as we go through the final two swimmers. Two in a line. France just drifting off the pace because Italy are back in contention. It's Zazzeri of Italy against Becker of the United States. Mignon for France, closer to us in lane six. And the Australians have still got some work to do.
And the margin at that turn was just 0.24 of a second, with the Italians desperately trying to steal this away from the USA's dominance. But Becker is not going to give it up. They're sitting right on the world record line. Canada's putting in a good performance over in lane number one.
Well, the Canadians not out of this yet. That was a huge takeover from the Americans.
That was tight. Have to watch that for the end. But into the water now is Zac Apple, the anchor for the USA.
So the United States nearly a body length clear. The battle behind them between France, Mehdi Metella, and had a huge anchor leg for the France in the heat. Italy in second place at the moment with Frigo, and the Canadians not out of this yet.
Great underwater by Apple. He completely missed that wash and chop of the big boys racing 100 freestyle by staying underwater. 25 metres to go.
America look good for another gold medal. They are so dominant in this freestyle, really. But the battle for the minor medals as Australia come on the charge. Italy looks safe for the silver, but it seems as though Australia are going to move themselves into contention for bronze. The United States take it in a 3:08.97, followed by Italy just... And Australia on the charge have managed to win another medal.
Just shy of the world record from the USA, 3:08.97. Official results, so it looked like that changeover was okay. It was the tightest of changeovers from swimmer number three to swimmer number four for the USA. Equal responsibility. The swimmer coming in needs to finish on a full stroke. You also need to judge well and have the weight of your toe still on the blocks when they touch. What a performance. Traveling on the replays with the USA. They led from start to finish. France threw everything at them with Manadou.
And really, the Manadou in the engine room put France in contention here. Now they were to drift out of the medals in the closing stages as the Americans took over at the front of this, and there was going to be no doubt about the winner once we got to the final leg. Question was Italy going to hang on, and what could Kyle Chalmers do to drag Australia up from away from the medals into third place and challenging the Italians for silver? That's how close it was between Italy and Australia on the touch.
Oh, they continue their dominance of this 4x100 freestyle relay. Australia got them in Sydney 2000. France got them in 2012, but they have been a dominant force in relay swimming.
Well, they had won 9 out of 12 editions of this 4x1 freestyle relay. That makes it 10 in 13 here in Tokyo. And the Americans are all smiles, as they should be. Dressel giving them the perfect start, measure of things to come for Caeleb Dressel. He's going to be a busy man through the Tokyo 2020 program. The results confirmed. 3:08.97 for the Americans. Italy hanging on in front of a fast finishing Australia. Canada having to settle for fourth place on this one. They were in the mix up until about 25 metres to go, but just didn't have the strength to hang on. So it's USA, Italy, Australia, the top three in the men's 4x1 freestyle relay.
Ladies and gentlemen, the victory ceremony for the men's 4x100 metre.
This is the victory ceremony for the men's 4x1 freestyle team. Victory for the United States. They are the dominant nation in freestyle sprinting.
and freestyle team sprinting. They have now won 10 gold medals across 13 Olympic Games where this has been an event. Italy gave a terrific battle, but when the questions were asked, the United States had the answers. The Australian team once again rising to the rostrum, finding a way onto the to win the medals against a highly competitive set of teams. Canada were pushing them all the way. France had something to say about it, but in the end, Australia take the bronze. America always find a way to win in these relays, not always, but more often than not. And this quartet, led by Caeleb Dressel, never really had the gold medal in doubt. There's some famous names here in the medal presentation party.
Mustafa Lafoui, the FINA Honorary Life President, Algerian, that led the organization for decades. We think about relay splits, and we saw what Caeleb Dressel had at the leadoff for the USA. He went a 47.2. Australia got themselves into this bronze medal position with a 46.44 by Kyle Chalmers. What a fast split by Chalmers.
Yeah, it's a monster swim from Kyle Chalmers, and the Australians needed it because they were behind the rest of the field until Chalmers came in, and they were still behind with 25 metres to go, and it was only the work of Kyle Chalmers and the fastest split across the field of 46.44. They were in 7th place at the midpoint, 5th place when Chalmers dived in, and then finished in 3rd. They were never going to catch the Americans. It was unlikely they were going to catch the Italians, but they made a very good effort in finishing just 11 100ths behind Italy in the event. But magnificent swimming. Kyle Chalmers delivers for Australia.
His best relay split previously was 46.6. So here in Tokyo, 46.44. Just puts him ahead of one of Alain Bernard's performances in a relay.
Italy for the silver. Miressi giving them a lead off on a 47.72, and then they work their way down. All four swimmers on 57 point. Pick of the bunch was Lorenzo Zazzeri with a 47.31. Anchored by Manuel Frigo, he could sense the Australians coming back at him. He was trying desperately to hang on to the feet of the Americans. They were anchored by Zach Apple. It wasn't to be. They did the job they needed to do, and it's silver for Italy. A magnificent performance for the Italian quartet. The first medal ever in this event.
Safe changeovers for Italy as well. Remember, we were looking at Zach Apple's changeover going, oh, that looked tight. We actually get the splits for the changeovers, and he was 0.05. So if he had have been just 6/100ths earlier, he would have been disqualified. So that was precision, perfect.
Gold medalist and Olympic champion, United States of America.
The Olympic champions then, the United States of America. An amazing team. What would it be like to be part of the US Olympic swim team? It's a team above all. They've had success, sustained success, for 60 years of international swimming. Is there ever a team in all sport as dominant as the US swim team? I don't think there is.
That success continues. They've only been beaten a few times in this event over history. The South Africans got them on one occasion. The Australians and the French have beaten them. But since the inception, they have won every 4x100 freestyle relay. Zac Apple's split was a 46.69 in anchoring this victory to the USA.
And here we are again for the second time at these championships, the national anthem of the United States.
Mesdames et messieurs, les médaillés olympiques. Ladies and gentlemen, the Olympic
stunning performance from the United States in the men's 4x1 freestyle relay. They continue their dominance in this event in front of Italy and Australia. Great race to round off the day three finals and semi-finals program. A program that has featured some magnificent swimming, some very close races, and the closest to finishes where every hundredth of a second counts. The Americans now with two gold, three silver and three bronze medals from 2 days of finals. Eight medals to the Americans. Six medals for Australia, two of them gold. Titmus adding to the women's 4x1 success from the first day of finals.
As they take their victory lap to record the moment for the cameras of the world. It's been a great day two finals.
So the athletes bonded together by the medals that they've won for each other and with each other. And there is something unique about swimming in a relay as opposed to an individual performance. Connected for life. Every time you look at the medal, you have to think of those who also won the medal with you. Jenny Thompson from the United States, who won, is one of the most decorated American athletes of all time, used to say how much she had given to other teams, so to other athletes.
Caeleb Dressel's just thrown his Olympic Games gold medal up to a relay heat swimmer who is in the stands. Now, the heat swimmers will get their medals. They get them at a later time, but he's... I'm impressed that he was able to throw that up without it damaging it, but it's been caught in the stands by one of the heat swimmers for that team. Really nice gesture.
Yes, there is an argument that all the heat swimmers should join the finalists on the rostrum because they all play their part and it is a team. It's not four swimmers that win the gold medal, it's everyone that takes part that wins the gold medal.